clear the room.
You're alive after all these years.
I could say the same about you, Mr. April. Captain Hunt.
I prefer Dylan.
That's refreshingly honest of you.
Venetri, why are you doing this to me?
After you left Mobius, I took the liberty of uncovering your true identity. Not very difficult. The High Guard Golden Boy, flying about in his great starship, defending the Commonwealth's interests. When I learned that you had perished, I felt a loss. And then, I saw this. You, back from the dead, working to restore the old Commonwealth. Two worlds signed up already. I noticed that the leader of one of those new worlds suffered an unfortunate accident.
He was murdered by his own people.
Where have I heard that before?
Is that why you had me brought here? What, because you think
I don't think. I know. I know you, Mr. April. I know how you work. I know what you do. And I don't want to see you succeed again.
What the hell happened to you?
You happened.
Where are you taking us?
Don't worry, you've already gone farther than any of the others.
The others? We're not the first?
Didn't you know?
How many attempts?
A dozen. Look, I know I should have helped them, but Farron was... Look, I will lead you through, I promise, okay?
I thought you were dating our sponsor's niece.
Maybe that's why she sent me.
Hold on. Pheromone sensors. They recognize body odor. And people they don't recognize, they kill.
You actually designed all these death traps?
A good architect brings physical form to the dreams of his clients.
Yeah, in your case, your client is a paranoid dictator.
Unfortunately. Wait. This is what I've told you about.
It's been a while since I've played hopscotch.
Especially the kind where a misstep could blow off your foot.
So how did you get mixed up with a butcher like Farron?
I won a contest. He picked my design for the Arc de Victoire. Then all the rest followed. Dominion Library, Nolendorf Station. But then, I brought him my most fantastic vision yet. The Cathedral of Light.
What happened?
I told him it would elevate the spirit of the people. But he smashed it with both fists.
That's going in. How do we get out with someone who doesn't want to leave?
Mr. March, I think you're becoming a pessimist.
I'm a realist, and I think we need to revisit a realist solution. Farron should be eradicated.
I was told Farron would live.
Farron will live.
Read between the lines, Mr. April. Our sponsors want Farron gone. They sent 12 teams in to make sure he'd be gone. When all 12 failed, they sent us. That's how much our sponsors care about saving lives.
There's a difference between risking lives and ending them.
The only difference is in who dies. If the choice is between his survival or ours, I choose ours. What do you think, Mr. May?
I'm an architect. I build things. Walls, ceilings. All I want is peace, sanity, cathedrals.
What you want, what we all want, is to exert our will over others.
It's too quiet in here.
All right. We are born, sworn, jealous friends of solitude. Of our own deepest, most midnight, most midday solitude.
You know, Tyr, a lot of people think you're selfish because you're always reading, you're always lifting, and you're always exercising. But the way I see it, I think you are just always trying to improve yourself. I never had that luxury. I never really got into the philosophy thing, you know.
But you've been too busy surviving. I respect that. Still, there's a great deal Nietzsche could teach you.
Like what?
To create your own values. To live life consistent with your deepest instinctual drives.
Such as?
Survival.
Got it covered. What else?
Reproduction.
I'm gonna lift some more weights.